You won't ever find the more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
You know the rules. No droids, no bounty hunters, no Raylos, no nobodies, no Disney canon fans of any kind. They'll be thrown out. No trolls. We ban you after we bit you out. All right. Anyway, it's very interesting. I've been bombarded by a lot of people asking me about this. You saw what's going on Twitter. And Drunk 3PO basically watched the whole thing go down in real time. Here's the deal. Apparently, Pablo Hidalgo, in his private little, secure little Twitter world, was mocking Star Wars theory over his reaction video to Luke's return. And the usual big channels made a big deal about it. You know, without, I'm sure there was a blog, I'm sure Itchy made a blog, I think that's where some of this all came from. Here's the deal. He's been quiet for a year. He's kept his mouth shut. He's left the fans alone for over a year, I think. And I remember debating with Itchy. Itchy said, oh, he'll be back in a few months. He hasn't come back. He has not made his Twitter profile public. Now, he could anytime he wanted, but he hasn't. Okay. This guy is well known to have, when someone in charge basically tells him to cut the hell out, have a major league temper tantrum, and then it goes to ground so he can complain to his friends without anybody going, grow the fuck up. Now, do you understand where I'm going with this? Here's the thing. If he hasn't been doing this for a year, and now he suddenly shows up, and if you look at his bio, I mean, it's right in front of their faces. Drunk3PO posted it. Jeremy Griggs at Geeks and Gamers posted it. It's been sent to Itchy. It says retired, having fun. The only things that he's changed were the covers. It went from a train to a his tweet about Star Wars theory, emotions shouldn't be shared, to a picture to people I don't know. But that's it. That's the only thing that's changed. So what's really going on here? Okay. 75% of me says he's trolling, but he's got it out there for everybody to see. I'm the only one that picked it up. Now, I sent it on to a friend of mine who's going to bring it up at the Dark Council. 75% of me says he's trolling. The other 25% says, and this is from actually paying attention to Disney's financial issues. Remember all of the videos I did last fall and last summer about just how bad they're actually doing? And if they're not, if they can't, they haven't been allowed to open up Disneyland. And the only sure bet money stream they have, revenue stream, are the parks. Disney World's wide open because Governor DeSantis isn't an idiot, and he's not a power monger. Disneyland is close to as tight as you could get it. I mean, even with crazy glue, gorilla glue, because Gavin Newsom is a jackass and likes wielding power over people, and he thinks he's better than everybody else. Okay, fine. They don't have any money. So, and then you've got the layoffs coming. You've got cast members being laid off. But there was that they were going into the studios too to fire people. Well, fire I mean, there was that story that Clownfish TV put up about one of the big named Imagineers that was kind of forced into retirement. And it's going into the studios. It's going into Marvel. It's going into a lot of them. Lucasfilm isn't untouchable here. So when I look at all of that and I see what Pablo posted there, I go, and the simple reason is this. It is not what a man says. It's what he does or does not do that says what's really going on. Okay. We have him screaming and ranting and raving and going dark and going into private, secure Twitter world for over a year. He didn't come out, left fans alone. Suddenly he's back. Okay. That's kind of weird. Does it say he's not at Lucasfilm? We've also got him, this is an action, not just saying it, this is an action, putting retired having fun in his Twitter bio. Is he trolling us? Probably. But again, take a look at what Disney's been doing since this COVID shit has really messed them up. And I'm going to say this. If you're looking at their shares thinking, oh my God, they're not doing well at all. If you're an SJW or even a member of the Phantom Menace and thinks that Disney just has money growing on trees, they do not. Okay? Nobody is too big to fail on this. All right? And they're being looked at hard for antitrust violations. Okay? Y'all don't remember that. Y'all don't look at this stuff, and you should, because it tells you a lot more about what's going on inside the company than having some unhappy, jealous, bitter, 400-pound, 45-year-old man baby like, red diaper baby, Pablo Hidalgo, mocking fans, all right? Tells you a hell of a lot more, and you should be looking at that. That's actually, you should see a lot of stuff that Disney's doing right now with their employees, because your biggest expenditure will always be your payroll, okay? That's why you see NFL teams letting big price players go, all right? They can't afford it under their salary cap. That's why you see people shrinking different parts of their companies because they can't afford all of it. They're looking for redundancies. These four people do the job of two people. Who's been there the longest? All right. Normally you keep them, but a lot of times they let them go because they make more money. Okay. That's why they are let go of that one Imagineer, that famous one whose name I can never remember. And this is a theory. This isn't rumor. It's based on Pablo's action of putting retired having fun in his Twitter bio and what Disney's been doing. He has caused them a lot of trouble. He has been one of the most vocally obnoxious jerks at Lucasfilm. And I can't imagine Jon Favreau and even Dave Filoni, let alone George Lucas, who's hovering in the background like Yoda's Force Ghost, putting up with this shit. I can't. And you gotta look at it. If you're a money person, you walk in and goes, I wanna see your books. So you go into the publishing side, which, I mean, Pablo Hidalgo's the head of the story group, is he not? Or was, whatever that means anymore. And you're looking at the authors. You're looking at what their books sold. You're looking at the fact that one of the authors who wrote the three Aftermath novels got fired for being a jackass on Twitter. That would be the other red diaper baby in this, Chuck Wendig. And you're like, this guy hasn't been successful. And then you start looking at his history of mocking and attacking fans and bullying fans. I mean, I know people wrote letters to Disney over this. I know that the people at Disney, not necessarily at Lucasfilm, know that he is a bad, bad, bad person and should not be anywhere near the franchise. And I'm gonna say this, if they know, you bet your sweet ass Favreau and Filoni knows. Filoni's on Twitter, he sees it. You know, he might not be everybody's cup of tea, but at least he doesn't go on Twitter attacking fans. Okay, that's a mark of actual class, okay? And I don't want to hear about his kowtowing to the feminazis and that at that conference. That conference took place in 2015 when Kathy Kennedy was flying on a broom circling Hollywood like she was the greatest thing since sliced bread. Because, of course, in her teeny tiny mind, she thinks she's the first head of a major studio, which I'm sure, you know, Sherry Lansing and Dawn Steele are like, what? We were there a long time before she, you know. But hey, you know, let her and the SJWs there have their delusions, okay? So my question is, why aren't people noticing this? Part of it is they don't want to believe it, all right? And, you know, you got to take stuff, that anything that this person does, Pablo, with a healthy dose of skepticism. However, it's still there in front of your face. So you should at least acknowledge it, okay? So he's attacking fans now after a year of not. He's doing it, of course, within his private little Twitterverse. But still, it got out. And Star Wars Theory put it out there. Now, I guarantee you, whoever got it to him is being looked at with a long, hairy eyeball by Pablo and has probably been blocked and kicked out of there. I mean, is that really a club any of us want to be a part of? Beyond spying so we could mock him? I don't know. Anyway, just, you know, putting it out there. Anyway, but you know, why would he do that? Well, nothing Pablo Hidalgo has done, and I explained what a person who does the books, a money guy, would be doing, looking at the absolute abject failure of the novels, the comic books, all of it. The abject failure of all of it. All right. And you'd be looking at his behavior. Pablo, when he was public, might as well have been on Fifth Avenue, Fifth and Broadway, screaming his head off like some crazed, fanatic, religious figure. I mean, Twitter's as public as you can get it when you do shit like that. You would probably say, you know, if we're looking to downsize Lucasfilm, this is where we start. This guy's bad for business. A, he doesn't know what he's doing. B, any product that he's either created or been part of its creation has failed miserably. And he causes way too much public outcry. And he doesn't really understand the customer. He's got to go. Retirement. Because that's what they're doing. But why is he public now? Why did this get public? And why did he say it? I'll tell you this, my theory, because all this is based on theory and what I've been seeing happening with his account and what Disney's been doing since the COVID thing has hit. I think he's jealous. I think he's horribly jealous of the success. He sees the ST coming to an end. And I really don't care what the skeptics, and I can name them, think. You can't get Jake Skywalker from what we saw at the end of Mando. You can't. Okay? You know, I really think that people, that there's a set of younger people, they're probably 40 and younger, who are not able to think critically and look for things that are deeper underneath the surface. I really, really think. It's in your face, and they're still like, yeah, but the sequels. And it doesn't matter if they're Phantom Menace or, you know, SJWs, they can't put two and two together. They don't see what's really going on because their parents didn't teach them to think critically. They weren't taught to think critically and they're too lazy to do it now. Okay, that's fine. Anyway, I mean, I'm not saying everybody. I mean, there are some that say, yeah, this is a retcon. And well, yeah, it is a retcon. But why did I do it? Well, he's jealous. Mando, that episode crushed Disney's server, all right? Good. Okay, good. That's good. Carrot of the stick approach. When they do something right, Mando, they get a carrot. Or my dog says, good boy, good boy. And when they do something stupid, the sequel trilogy, they get the shock collar up to 100, you know, and they'll never do it again. That's how you do it, carrot or stick. There's more to be learned from your mistakes than there is from your successes. And Disney didn't really start learning anything from their from doing Star Wars until TLJ fell flat on its face, till Solo, a Star Wars Story, lost $250 million, till Tross barely skipped over $1 billion and probably lost money. Okay, you gotta look at the money though. Again, if you're a Phantom Menacer, quit acting like you know everything and do your homework before you come back here and start yelling at me or anybody else. But why is he doing this? He's jealous of their success. He's bitter that that the sequel trilogy has not been successful. Do you see any shows being made about Rey? Yeah, the Lego show that was started 3 years ago. And they were still thinking they could make money off of this dumpster fire. All right. You gotta look at the time period it takes to make something like that. You can't just go, yeah, but. Again, thinking critically is very important here. All right, listen to me. But also, you've got to see, I mean, he's jealous, he's angry. And I'm gonna say this personally, he is not a Star Wars fan. He didn't show up at Lucasfilm because he embraced the franchise the way a real fan would. He went there to fuck it up. Okay, he is a left wing, he's a red diaper baby, he's an activist. That's what he does. He doesn't know anything about what Lucas wanted to do. I'm sure if at meetings when he would show up and George would say, no, we're not going to do that, he'd get mad. Everything that he has done, that he's chosen, the authors he's chosen, all the rest of this, have been a direct middle finger to everything that came before it, because he was never a fan. Okay, these people, these SJWs, and he is one of them, invaded our culture to fuck it up. What is the most moving propaganda thing you can do, that you can create? Moving pictures. Battleship Potemkin. Triumph of the Will. Anything that was made during the Cultural Revolution in Red China. There you go. I mean, he's no different. These people are no different from Julius Stryker and the rest of the propagandists in Nazi Germany, Soviet Russia, and Mao's China. They're not there to make a beautiful culture, to be part, to add to the conversation. They're there to force an agenda and change and shape people's opinions. That's it. This is why nihilism creeped into TFA, TLJ, and The Rise of Skywalker. All right? These people don't know how to write scripts. I mean, if someone says Larry Kasdan, I just look at him and say, Larry Kasdan is done. He's done, okay? Left-wing SJW stuff, left-wing fascism, is the ultimate expression of nihilism, period, full stop. And Pablo Hidalgo is a nihilist on steroids, just like Ryan Johnson, and ultimately just like Kathleen Kennedy. What they believe in is nothing. They can say they believe in something, but ultimately it comes to nothing. Okay. And of that, the chaos that they want is born. All right. What is more chaotic than The Force Awakens? What is more nihilistic than The Last Jedi? What is more chaotic and nihilistic and lazy than The Rise of Skywalker? What is just a dumpster fire more than Solo, a Star Wars Story? Think about it. Is Pablo still there? I'm going to use my skeptics. 75% says he's trolling with that retired having fun thing. 25% says, watching what Disney's been doing, it would not surprise me if he's no longer working there. Hence, why this all started to come out. Because if he was still answering to the mouse, he might be really, really quiet right now. You know, and the bitterness and the jealousy and the anger, that's all you need to know. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you.